Environmental news now. The Our Ocean Summit featured several commitments from African nations. VOA's Caroline Turner has more.
One African nation making commitments at the Our Ocean Conference is Mauritius, a small developing country located in the Southwest Indian Ocean.
The lives, livelihoods, and traditions of Mauritians have been inextricably linked to the ocean. For us, the ocean economy and the national economy are indistinguishable.
A World Bank study notes that 30% of the fish stock is depleted in the Southwest Indian Ocean. The Mauritius government identifies overfishing and climate change as the two leading contributors to the declining health of the oceans.
Inaction will exacerbate the negative effects, the negative impacts affecting the lives of poor people and threatening the environment on which all life depends.
The government is taking steps to promote ocean health, both for the public good and as a strategic national development priority.
To pursue these objectives, we have created a dedicated Ministry of the Ocean Economy and a National Ocean Council to drive the development strategy, set up a Continental Shelf Maritime Zone Administration and Exploration Department to develop the offshore hydrocarbon and mineral sectors in Mauritius, developed a Port Master Plan which will enable Mauritius to become a major maritime hub, and created an exclusive economic zone.
Mauritius claims a maritime zone that represents nearly 1% of the world's ocean.
Ocean health is also impacted by other interconnected challenges, such as rapid population growth, threats to biodiversity, including the marine environment, and social and economic insecurity. Interventions will consequently require sound policies, increased investments, greater innovation, all backed by rigorous science-based evidence, which can help guide the creation of policies that are growth-inducing, fair, free from political bias, and more importantly, benign to the environment.
Other African nations made commitments at the Our Ocean Conference. Senegal announced the launch of a $120 million artificial reef immersion program to restore degraded marine areas and rehabilitate the fisheries sector. The Republic of Congo announced plans to create a special marine conservation zone of 1,900 square kilometers to protect sea turtles and sharks. The Safe Ocean Network has brought together 46 governments to combat illegal fishing around the world. The United States announced USAID activities worth $55 million U.S. dollars over 5 years for Indonesia, the Philippines, and West Africa. The Fish Eye Africa Task Force enables authorities to take action against large-scale illegal fishing in 8 African countries. Carolyn Turner, VOA News, Washington.